Lockheed Martin just announced CMMT, Comet. By all accounts, this seems to be their answer to mass manufacturing and asymmetric warfare. The idea that multi-million dollar missiles can only take out $1,000 drones for so long. And perhaps an answer to Anduril's Barracuda missile, one of the biggest shocks of 2024. Comet may just be a single product, but it's one of the first major outcomes of a much larger movement within Lockheed. One that seems to echo some of the Skunk Works ethos of the past. The program that landed us some of the most impressive aircrafts built on some of the most aggressive timelines. In this video, I'm going to discuss the lead up to Comet and 1LMX, the largest internal program ever undertaken by Lockheed. Iranian-made Shahed drones cost between $20,000 and $50,000 per unit. In the Red Sea, the US Navy has been forced to defend against Houthi attacks by deploying enormously expensive interceptors. SM-2 missiles cost $2.1 million each. SM-6 missiles cost $4.3 million each. SM-3 missiles range from $9.6 to $28.7 million each. In just 15 months, from October 2023 to January 2025, the Navy fired more air defense missiles than in the previous 30 years, spending over $1 billion on these interceptors. In Ukraine, Russia has launched over 14,700 one-way attack drones since 2022, with Iranian Shaheds making up the majority of those. With a large-scale technology transfer from Iran, Russia reportedly produced 6,000 of these drones in 2024, and they only have plans to increase that this year in 2025. This is a story of cost, just as much as it's a story of scale and stockpiles. Let's backtrack a little further. Anduril has completely changed the defense conversation in the US. They have launched product after product, all built to connect to their advanced AI software, Lattice, and all with their own money. They prove that a forward-looking defense technology company that builds products in anticipation of future needs can win over build-to-spec contracts. In 2024, Anduril unveiled Barracuda, its family of autonomous cruise missiles designed for hyperscale production. 30% cheaper, 50% less time to produce, 95% fewer tools required, and 50% fewer parts. Sources say the Barracuda is estimated to cost less than $200,000 per unit, a fraction of the cost of traditional cruise missiles. Months later, in early 2025, Lockheed Martin unveiled the Common Multi-Mission Truck, CMMT, or Comet, a low-cost, modular cruise missile designed to be produced at scale. In its basic configuration, it's estimated to cost $150,000. Modular designs allow for various payloads, and it's compatible with a bunch of different launch platforms. Comet represents a major shift in Lockheed's approach. Rather than focusing exclusively on high-end missiles like $1.2 million JASSMs, Lockheed is creating a complementary high and low product mix. Mike Rothstein, VP of Strategy at Lockheed Martin Missiles and Fire Control, explained the Air Force and the DoD need not only exquisite weapon systems that Lockheed is known for, but also more affordable options. And Comet is designed to be just good enough for many operational needs while being dramatically more affordable. Perhaps the most important part, Comet is built around a new manufacturing approach. Lockheed describes it as a factory that fits inside of a room, easy to replicate and deployable anywhere in the world. That seems like a pretty good hint that our partners are going to be involved as well. Comet isn't just a new product. It's the result of a massive program at Lockheed Martin called 1LMX. 1LMX represents the largest internal reorganization in company history, a multi-billion dollar investment to re-engineer Lockheed's processes from the ground up. With a manufacturing-first approach, designing for production from day one, design reusability, accelerated development timelines, and distributed modular production capabilities. The first product of L1MX, Rapid Dragon, kicked off in early 2021 with a blank sheet of paper. With Rapid Dragon, Lockheed participated in 3 customer exercises, conducted their first flight, all within the first 10 months. With Comet, Lockheed claims it reduced the time to preliminary design review by 50% compared to traditional programs. For decades, US military doctrine has been built around small numbers of build-to-spec, exquisite, high-performance platforms and munitions. Today's conflicts are revealing the limitations of this approach against adversaries employing large numbers of good enough systems at dramatically lower costs. Modern defense technology, and now big traditional manufacturers like Lockheed Martin, are taking this in and they're refactoring their approach. It's not going to be an overnight journey, building new factories, retooling, incorporating perhaps new manufacturing technology and approaches. This is going to be a multi-year, perhaps multi-decade approach, but it seems like the trend is not going anywhere. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing, leave a like, and if you have any new defense news or military tech news, drop it in the chat. I'd love to read it. I'd love to see it. Thanks. We'll see you in the next one.